I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Carol is lip-syncing her heart out to her favorite gospel song called Overcomer. It's a bold choice for a little girl who has spent more time inside Oakland Benioff Children's Hospital than she has outside. Some of her closest playmates are the nurses treating her for severe congenital neutropenia. It's a rare blood disorder where bone marrow is unable to make normal white blood cells. Dr. Allison Matsunaga was one of the first to treat her.
She has issues with just normal feeding, so she's required many different treatments.
To distract Leah from boredom and sometimes pain. Her mother looked for songs on the internet. That's how Leah became a fan of gospel singer Mandisa. It was this one video of Leah singing Overcomer that transformed the pint-sized patient into an internet sensation with more than 37 million views. Lindsay is Leah's mother.
What is it about that video that you think resonates with people?
The world needed some joy right now, especially in the United States. I think Leah just has this pure joy about her.
Leah has survived two bone marrow transplants and numerous side effects.
And the song itself is just really, really fitting for her life.
Little Leah's voice has inspired both the sick and healthy, who have posted comments on her video from around the world, even inspiring Mandisa herself.
It's Mandisa!
What?
Doctors say Leah's neutropenia is close to being cured, earning her the nickname Leah the Overcomer.
Why, hello there! This is your compassion lesson for today. Each of us, every single one of us, all of us, it doesn't matter your age, it doesn't matter who you are, every single one of us has the ability as well as the opportunity to help others. All you have to do is do something nice for someone. That's it. It's all you have to do. You don't have to be a missionary in a foreign country. You can start with your own family or your classmates, your friends, the people around you. If you have love for others, it will be a natural desire to have compassion. Here is a testimony statement from someone who has let God guide their life. Her name is Julie Jones. I grabbed my passport and headed to the airport bound for Rwanda with the Rafiki Foundation. I can have compassion for others because God has compassion for me. He fulfills all my needs so that I may help others in need. I am weak, but He has given me strength, and He is strong. And I love because He first loved me. It's all Him, it's all grace. thank God every single day and know that He is working through us. Have a good day.
I have a lot of memories from when I was a child. One that's always stuck out to me, though, was when I was about 10 years old and I was in school and I struggled. And I didn't struggle with English, math, or science. I struggled holding still. And I would try to listen and focus and process ideas, but I couldn't help myself. And to be honest, I would sit there and then I would just start tapping. And the students in the class would look at me and they'd say, "Hey, stop tapping." A lot of the time, I didn't even realize I was doing it. And then eventually even the teachers got after me and they would yell at me and they'd say, "Clint, you have to stop tapping." It got so bad that I got sent to the principal's office for tapping. And he said to me, "Okay, maybe when you go back to class, just try sitting on your hands." And so I did. I went back to class, and when I felt myself starting to tap, I did this. I sat on my hands. And that worked for about 5 seconds. One time I was tapping in class, and my teacher, Mr. Jensen, he looked at me, and he yelled. And he said, "Clint, stay after class." And I thought to myself, this is it. I am done. Now, I've always been the type of person that believes that a single moment in time can change a person's life. And this was one of those moments for me, and I will never forget it. And so I was sitting there with Mr. Jensen and an empty classroom. And he walked past me and he sat next to his desk and he said, "Clint, come here, I want to talk to you." And as he looked me right in the eye, he said, "Now, I need you to know something, you're not in trouble, but I do have just one question that I have to ask you." And he asked, he said, "Have you ever thought about playing the drums?" And in that moment, Mr. Jensen, he leaned back and he opened the top drawer of his desk. And he reached in and he pulled out my very first pair of drumsticks. And he held them in his hands and he looked at me and he said, "Hey, Clint, you're not a problem. I think you're a drummer." Moment on, I've never put those sticks down. I've toured, recorded, and played drums all over the world. My whole college education was paid for with drumsticks in my hand. Just because of a single moment in time when somebody believed in me and he saw something in me that I didn't even see within myself. And from that moment, I learned that there's a difference between being the best in the world and being the best for the world.
Make yourself comfortable in your seat and close your eyes. Take in a deep breath and begin to relax. I'd like you to take your attention to the center of your chest. We will call this your heart center. Now imagine in this center there is a ball of light, a small ball of emerald green sparkling light. And within this light there are sparkles of pink and gold. And this light feels warm and soothing. It's a loving light deep within your body, deep within you. And this soothing ball of light is beginning to expand. You feel it now flowing over your face, an emerald green, loving and soothing light. Let it flow over your shoulders, relaxing, soothing you all the way down your arms to the tips of your fingers. Still in the center, in your heart center, you feel this ball of light as it flows outward, spreading over your body, relaxing the muscles of your back, flowing down your legs all the way to the tips of your toes. This beautiful light is flowing over and through and around your body, with the center of the ball of light still within your heart. Such a loving feeling, pure light of love, nurturing and soothing you and energizing you from within. A wonderful feeling. Relax and enjoy. And when you're ready, take a deep breath. And as you breathe out, just stretch out whatever feels good for you right now. You feel confident and strong, relaxed and free, and ready to enjoy the most wonderful day.